port city of Mombasa on this beautiful evening. In this video, I begin by congratulating His Excellency President William Samoei Ruto. The dust has settled, and even for those who are not seeing him as president, now they must accept that indeed William Samoei Ruto is the fifth president of the Republic of Kenya. So, congratulations. I also want to congratulate Rigathi Gachagua, not just for making it as number two, the Deputy President of the Republic of Kenya, but for defying odds, for proving many people wrong, for proving us wrong that indeed he was what we thought he was not. So, Rigathi Gachagua, Kongole, Kongole, Kongole. You have proved many people wrong. Many things were said about you. You are able to retain the Mount Kenya for William Samoei Ruto. I must own that I argued with you many times when a deputy president, and you kept insisting that you knew the Mount Kenya people, that these were sons and daughters of Mau Mau, and they were rebellious and they rebel against Uhuru Kenyatta. I never believed it, and I think I was not alone. So congratulations, Rigathi Gachagua. I'm sure you begin on the path not just of serving this country, not just of deputizing your president, but also on charting the path for the Mount Kenya people. At this juncture, I have no doubt in my mind whatsoever, that you, Rigathi Gachagua, are going to be the Mount Kenya kingpin, that in you, the people of Mount Kenya can now see a leader, because imagine those of us who are saying, Rigathi Gachagua hapa, Martha Karua hapa. All of us have been proved wrong. And for that reason, as you embark on your journey of being the Mount Kenya kingpin, we wish you the very best as you serve those people from that region and of the people of this country. Back to His Excellency, the President of the Republic of Kenya, William Samoei Ruto. I have this to say. I want to say that you started well. I have heard people whispering and saying, eh, did we have a president? Because in just a matter of hours and or a few days, you've been able to do so much that people are left wondering whether indeed we had a president. Congratulations once again for the energy, for the zeal, and for the speed. But in the same breath, Your Excellency, we will have to advise you a few things. One, do not be in a hurry to dismantle the opposition. Stop poaching the opposition. We need it. Number two, many people are asking, why are you moving with such a speed? That some of the things you are doing, like the issue of Morocco, those are issues that require people to sit down and think hard. I began hearing about this issue when I was in primary school. It's not an issue you can address in a tweet. People are also wondering, what was the hurry? What was the hurry with the issue of the subsidy? On day one, are you not playing into the hands of those who are saying, IMF has you under control, that you are doing this to please Mount Kenya? How would you remove fuel subsidy and other subsidies on day one of your work, unless there is a master you are trying to please? So please try and avoid that, because then Kenyans are wondering. Some of these things will require that cabinet, sits so that it is owned by government and not an individual, even if that individual be the President of the Republic of Kenya. So the speed with which you are doing some of these things is leaving a lot to be desired, and people are saying, let the president reduce the speed, let him appoint cabinet, let certain decisions, especially these heavy decisions, be made by cabinet. And those of us who are saying so because we love this country. We will want your government to succeed. Government will succeed if you are seen to be talking on behalf of government, so that it's also government talking and not the President of the Republic of Kenya talking. Including things like saying you will not work with the opposition in terms of forming government. Things that you put on record are rarely easy to change. Remember, I wish to remind you, Your Excellency, in 2013, you went out loudly saying that your government that you formed with Uhuru Kenyatta would not have a single politician. The president then proceeded to put Ngilu, Charity Ngilu, Balala, and a few other politicians. That meant your word was not taken seriously. So, avoid the hasty moves you are making now. Because for you to succeed, you must make decisions that can withstand time, decisions that actually convince Kenyans have been made after serious consideration, where consultation is necessary, you've made those consultations, where government institutions involved are actually engaged, where parliament should be engaged, is engaged through its committees, where cabinet must make part of the decisions, cabinet makes those decisions. So it's important, Your Excellency, that you reduce the speed, you name your cabinet first, and then you can move and make some of those changes and make some of the pronouncements. But while at it, just a word of advice. The people of this country were expecting that you reduce the price of bread, the price of unga, the price of fuel. I support you 101% in terms of subsidies. A country like ours where people have no value, where people are cheats, refunds I do not support. Because it reminds me of the export compensation of the 1990s, I think 80s and 90s, of the Goldenberg scandal. Even these VAT refunds, I don't support those things. So I support you in terms of subsidy. But I also want to challenge government. Instead of giving subsidies, why don't you just remove certain levies on petrol? Remove levy 1, levy 2, road levy, whatever levy. Then the petrol can be almost affordable. So once again, Your Excellency, congratulations for winning this tough war. Many people never expected you to win. You have won. Congratulations, Rigathi Gachagua, for bringing a lot to the campaign, the passion, the zeal, the fight in you. And it's for that reason, Honorable Rigathi Gachagua, I have no doubt that Mount Kenya in you will find a leader as they move forward. Now to Raila Odinga. Baba is back. Many people have been asking me, what about Raila? Where is Raila going? Is he too old? Is he retiring? And if yes, is he supporting Kalonzo? Who is he supporting? Is Azimio finished? My answer has been simple. Raila Odinga is a man I can only dismiss when he's no longer around. That question was put to me in 2013. I told people, the Raila I know, I cannot say he's finished until it is over for him. 2017, everybody thought he was gone. I told them, the Raila I know, I cannot dismiss him. A couple of months later, he was in the handshake. And he has been important in this country until this election. So anybody dismissing Raila is doing so at his own peril. Is Raila too old? The answer is certainly no. The world has witnessed many serious old leaders that have led their countries into serious successes, much older than Raila would be 5 years from now. 5 years from now, Raila will be 82 years old. In 1992, his father stood when he was 81 years old. Age, they say, is but a number. But Raila himself has now come to answer the question. Where is Raila? Raila has come back fighting. He's saying it's not over until it's over. He sent notice, raised flag He's saying he's going to check the judiciary because the Supreme Court, according to him, have misbehaved to the extent he thinks they ought not to be in that court. That is going to ensure they go home. The Supreme Court judges, some of you are my friends, take note. When Raila speaks, if he says your wife is pregnant, please begin buying the things you need for a wife who gives birth. So when Raila says the Supreme Court judges could go, please take heed. Raila has come back and is telling us IBC will have to be changed. I want to offer my suggestion to IBC. IBC, we should go back to the 1997 IPG model, where political parties bring commissioners. Next, we need to have a different working engagement between the commission and the secretariat, so that the commission is not necessarily 100% permanent and executive. We need to blend between an executive secretariat and an executive commission. That will be necessary going forward. For the Supreme Court, I want to offer a suggestion, because I've observed what's going on in this country. For the Supreme Court, I suggest we have 9 judges, not 7. And out of the 9, I want to suggest that 4 judges be from the Commonwealth and 5 be Kenyan. When we had the Truth and Justice and Reconciliation Commission, we had slots for foreign commissioners. Those foreign commissioners did not sign the report because it was not a reflection of what they had come to gather. In the same manner, if we have 4 judges from the Commonwealth, we may not end up with the kind of things we seem to be ending up with now. And finally, Raila has suggested that they are going to look at the Constitution afresh. I want to remind judges of the High Court, the Justice Ngugi bench, judges of the Court of Appeal, I have forgotten the president of the Appeal Court. Please forgive me. But Kiage there. Kiage gave us the historical approach to the change of constitution. And he said, we need to go to the villages, do public participation, civic education, then come the constituency assembly way. I said that time that was a dangerous thing. Imagine you are a president and somebody is roaming the countryside, engaging people. My friend, is disaster. So I asked William Samoei Ruto's government to prepare for the disaster that may be in the making by way of these constituent assemblies. Because once you go down, you actively involve citizens. When the constituent assembly finally meets in Nairobi, that is Kenya. That will be Kenya talking, and Kenya can make far-reaching decisions. But all in all, we hope that whatever we do, whatever processes we engaged in, whether we are Raila or Ruto, whoever it is, that we maintain peace, because this is our country. And again, from the port city of Mombasa, I say thank you for listening to me.